you used WebDAV to publish content into WebCT, you're probably going to want to do the same with Desire2Learn. Luckily, we have WebDAV support enabled on our Desire2Learn server, and I'll give you a quick demonstration of how to set up WebDAV with Dreamweaver. What I'm going to start with, though, is showing you how to identify the course information in your own course. Here in my course, next to the course that I'm an instructor in, there's a little pencil. And I can click on that, and it'll take me right to this, what would otherwise be the Edit Course area here, with a Course Offering Path. And that's actually where the content for your course is located. So I'm going to select that, copy it, and switch over to Dreamweaver. Now, the Dreamweaver window is a little tight right now, but what we're going to do is define a new site. So in the Sites panel, go to Manage Sites. We'll create a new site. And I'm just going to call this Afried Test because that's the name of my course. And I'm going to create a new sample course to use. Now the remote information is where you put in the WebDAV. So under the Access pull-down, choose WebDAV. And the URL is fairly simple. It's http://pcclms-dav.desiretolearn.com, and then you paste in that path you copied from your course content. The last thing you want to do is type in your Desire2Learn username and password, and then try the test button. And you should get a confirmation if it works. I'm going to click the OK button, and now my site has been set up. It's blank now because the course was empty, so I'm going to start by adding a new file. We're just going to say WebDAV is as easy as 123. 1, get the URL. 2, get a WebDAV client. And 3, publish. Now, once I've saved it, we'll just call this index.html, and it's saved in my site here. So I'm going to select that and publish that to the server. And if we go back to my course, go to the content area, manage files, we can preview that and see there's the content. And I'm going to add this to my content area, and you can do that by simply clicking the Add Content topic, or I'm going to add it to the demonstration module. I'm going to keep that title, click Add, and then if we go to the manage, or the, go back to the content tool, there it is. Now you're probably wondering, what if I create a file right in Desire2Learn? Will it be available? The answer is yes. So we're going to create a new file, and we'll just say, call this one hollerback.html. Actually, it's not the file name, that's the title. I'll just use the default there. Say, and I'm just going to leave the default destination. Click Save. Go to the View Content area. There's our file. Switch back to Dreamweaver, and you'll have to look at the remote view and refresh that, and you'll now see that file you created. Don't show me that. And here's that document. I'm going to make a small stylistic change, make a small capitalization change, and save it, give it a title, and publish it back. Now, if we click on that item again, you'll see the updated version is now listed in the content. Fairly straightforward. And for more information or help on that, you can actually click on Help. Go to the Integration Packs, WebDAV, and there's information on how to set up WebDAV for both Windows and for the Mac OS. That's it.